There's some more good friends around the bend, so keep on keeping on.
There aren't enough words to describe how Joe Uncle Tote Cunningham impacted the island. Cunningham came to Guam through the Air Force and loved it so much he stayed. The Kentucky native touched the lives of many people, including longtime friend Cindy Hansen. They knew each other for over 28 years, first meeting as radio announcers. She learned of Uncle Tote's death on Facebook and called his phone in disbelief, only to hear his roommate's voice.
From what I hear, he hadn't been feeling well the day before, and they'd taken him to the hospital, and he ended up being released. The doctors thought he was fine. His roommate said that he was in great spirits, looked great. You know, they went out and had a meal, and Tote came home and was just chilling out, laying on the couch, reading a book, and next thing he was gone.
Hansen also credits him for her nickname, Sister Cindy, because he said she reminded him so much of his sister, Cindy. She talks about how she remembers him.
What was awesome about Joe was his zest for life. You know, he was always happy, always doing whatever he wanted to do. If he had a dream, he went after it.
Former K57 radio personality John Anderson says he was also shocked to hear about Uncle Tote's death. Anderson knew him when they worked together in radio and remembers his ability to pick up languages.
Uncle Tote, Tote was a special kind of person. He spoke for one thing, fluent Chamorro. He also spoke just as a little sidebar, a little Tagalog, a little Japanese. This guy was a linguist.
For he remembers him best for singing the Chamorro rendition of the Star Spangled Banner on K57 and at baseball games, before it was sung at then-President Bill Clinton's visit to Guam several years ago.
It was controversial. Some people didn't like it. They thought it was unpatriotic to take the Star Spangled Banner, the national anthem of the country, and change it to a different language. But many other people thought that was even more patriotic, to want to sing the national anthem of the United States in the native tongue of Guam, the Chamorro language.
He also talks about his youthful energy, especially during annual Liberation Day parades.
If there's another memory that sticks in my mind of Uncle Tote, it's a Liberation Day parade, and him rollerblading, skateblading up and down the side of the road with his camera in tow, you know, taking pictures of the crowds waiting for the parade.
For Hansen, what sticks out the most in her mind is how Uncle Tote set the bar high for how fathers should be. Hansen says Tote was a great father to his three children, Lindsay, Trey, and Brandon.
I have memories, you know, of him bringing his daughter Lindsay into the radio station with him, you know, when she was a baby, and then when Trey and Brandon came along, you know, he made a little soundboard for them, you know, so that when he'd bring Trey in, and then Brandon and Joe would be doing his show on the real board, and there'd be one of the babies there with their little wooden board that Daddy had made, mixing and playing right along, and now both boys are musicians.
She also talks about how Tote wrote about his life experiences, including how he wants his mortal molecules to be disposed. Hansen says Uncle Tote humorously wrote about how he wants to be buried at sea and how he doesn't want anyone crying but celebrating his big graduation of life. She reads an excerpt of what he wrote.
He said, "I've probably had more fun in my current lifetime than most have had in two or three. So when it's time for me to ditch my mortal molecules, rather than grieving for me, allow yourself to enjoy my graduation party and indulge yourself in a little mortuary humor." And that was Joe, right? Just always wanted people to laugh. And thank God he gave us so many wonderful memories, most of them hilarious, that we can have a really nice send-off for him. God bless you, Joe.